Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is the makeup look I have created today. I'm gonna show you guys a tutorial on how to do this eye look and also the lip I use, the lippy I've used. So stay tuned, don't go nowhere. Look what I've got, guys. Ah, it says Dicedchoco on it. So now no one can take this and try and say it's theirs because my name is on it, okay? So I've got this burgundy palette. So it's kind of like burgundy plum colors. So like these two are gonna go on my lid, and then on my crease I'm gonna put some here. Doing your eyeshadow and it looks like, oh, there's nothing, oh, I can't see nothing, like the color's not showing, and then you stop for a second and have a look and you think, wait, hold on, color's a bit strong still, but it's okay, we're gonna work with it, you know what I mean? So I'm basically just buffing that all over my crease. So I'm just gonna go in with my Quarry and Poppyseed color, and I'm literally just gonna whack that on my lid. And I'm kind of putting it on quite thick because I really want the color to show. So I'm gonna take this into a cut crease look. So I'm really gonna like drag this color up into like where I would kind of flick my eyeliner. I'm just gonna do the exact same thing on the other side. I know it looks quite messy.
Going to use some NC45 Studio Fix powder.
Now that we've whacked on our two eyeshadow colours, what I would usually do is put on black liquid liner, do my flip, and then trace in between the light colour eyeshadow and the dark colour eyeshadow the cut crease. But I find it easier to do my liquid liner after my eyelashes are on. And I'm going to draw the liquid liner to not kind of cover the poppy seed that I've put on my eyelid. So the reason I like to do my liner after I've glued my lashes on is because I have really small eyelids, and sometimes the lashes actually look like I've already got a liner going on across my eye. So I will just draw like the outer corner, and then I'll go in and draw the inner corner. And with the inner corner, I kind of like to drag it right in the inner corners of my eyes, so it's kind of like poking out of the eye. Again, I don't go all the way across the whole eye because
over my poppy seed again,
and you can kind of see the difference it makes already.
Oh, this eye is really warring and it's really getting on my nerves.
And I'm just going to like trace in between my light color and my dark color. I go for an even darker color, then it looks more dramatic. So yeah, so I'm literally going to trace. And then on the flick over the liner, I'm gonna be a bit more careful and leave the gap for the poppy seed to show even more. Buff that in without going over where I've kind of like traced.
And I'm going to go back with my crease brush. Is going to be
the color that I applied on my crease earlier on, and just so I'm going to go in with some Studio Fix powder.
When I open my eyes, like 44.5,
which is a lighter than my skin tone, and I'm just going to use that to tidy up the edges that we had going on. And again, the same powder is what I use to highlight under my eyes. So now I'm just gonna whack on some mascara and to highlight with some Melon pigment. So I don't know if you can see the color, but it's like a burgundy, dark rouge.
Rouge.
Like a dark blood red. So Drake. Oh, let me get my dad. I literally just bought it just the other day. And oh my god. And I can't even open it. Ah! It's probably strong, innit? Damn, this colour. Cut crease in the eye. And this is the final look, guys. yeah, I hope you guys like it. I like it, it's really like bold, sophisticated, you know. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, share. You know what? My dad's watching a Manchester United match and I just hear him shouting, so I hope this doesn't actually come out in my video. But anyway, like, comment, subscribe, share.